Perform the operations by hand, then use a calculator to check your work. So we've got some different operations going on here, so let's remind ourselves of the order of operations. We're going to do what's inside parentheses or other grouping tools first, and then we're going to do exponents, and then we're going to multiply or divide going left to right, then we're going to add or subtract going left to right. Always good to have this little checklist jotted down for yourself. Even if you know the order of operations, it's nice to have it sitting there looking at you on your page. So in this first problem, we see we have negative 5, and then we have negative 2 that's raised to the third power. It can be very tempting to just start working your way from left to right through this problem, but notice how that would be wrong. Negative 5 is being multiplied to the negative 2, but the negative 2 is being raised to the third power. Order of operation tells us we have to do exponents first. So we're going to do our exponents first. So negative 2 raised to the third power, remember what that means. That means negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. Okay, and we know that it's the negative 2 that's being raised to the power because the negative is inside the parentheses. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Positive 4 times negative 2 would give me negative 8. So this part here is going to come down as negative 8. But I want to be sure not to lose my parentheses, because notice if I forget to bring the parentheses down and I just write this, all of a sudden I have a subtraction problem. But remember, the negative 5 is multiplied to that negative 2 to the third power, so I need to be sure that the negative 5 gets multiplied to that result. Now we can do negative times a negative is a positive, and 5 times 8 is 40. So we can write our final answer that way. We could just write it as 40 itself. Sometimes it's helpful just to remind ourselves that we've thought about the sign by showing the plus sign. Second problem, we have some different things going on. There's no parentheses, and so what was subtraction or what was multiplication isn't there anymore. We have subtraction going on. So when we do our exponents first for this problem, it's not negative 2 that's being raised to the third power. Notice there are no parentheses holding that negative, protecting that negative sign with the 2. So this is going to be negative 5 minus, and this is just 2 to the third. 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8. So this is going to be negative 5. And in this case, it is just negative 5 minus 8. There's no multiplication here. And when I do negative 5 minus 8, that's going to give me negative 13. So let's use our calculator to check our work and make sure we've done these correctly. So in the first problem, we're going to put in multiplication signs in our calculator, so just in case it doesn't like the juxtaposition. So we're going to put in negative 5. And that's going to be multiplied to, and here we have to use these parentheses around that negative 2. Negative 2, we're going to close the parentheses. And now they're asking us to raise this to the third power. So we're going to use this caret right here, this little arrow, it looks like a little arrow up key. We're going to press that, and that's telling my calculator I'm going into an exponent. The exponent is 3. And when I press enter, I get my answer of 40, just like we thought we were going to. So that little exponent key is right there. That's called a caret. My second problem, remember, was slightly different, so let's clear this out and check this one. For this one, we had negative 5, and then remember we subtracted 2 raised to the third power. So there were no parentheses, so I don't want to put any parentheses in my calculator. So 2, and again, here's my caret, raised to the third power. When I press enter, there's my negative 13, just like I was expecting.